Hello, Battle Right fans, and welcome to Arenas at Dawn. I'm your host, ShadowFury333, and I'm playing Battle Right now. Now, I mean, I'm still going to be playing Zero K, for those of you watching me for the Zero K stuff, but I want to add Battle Right in essentially what was my fighting game slot, because it's kind of a mix between a fighting game and an RTS game in a lot of ways. I figure that's actually really appropriate for the channel. It's the sort of thing that fits, because it's basically both the things I love. Or both the types of games that I love a lot. So, gonna be starting out. Unfortunately, I don't really know if there's any way to do replays. These aren't really so much replays as they are just plays. Far as I can tell, there isn't really a replay database, which I find very annoying, and I'm gonna need something like that in order to properly cast this. I do want to cast this, like actually cast this spectator-wise in general. But I don't know any way to do that at this point. There doesn't seem to be a way in the game to actually that facilitates that sort of thing. So for now, just going to be playing the game. So, Battle Royale is a top-down, effectively combination shooter fighting game type thing. It's pretty much just an arena combat game. You also get this little thing at the very start of every single round where you get to choose abilities. You basically have 7 abilities, 2 of which have special modes. Just get there. 2 of which have special metered versions. So you usually have a couple basic attacks on your mouse buttons. You'll have usually an escape ability on the space bar or on the Q button. E is some type of special ability that's, in the case of my character, disables my opponent. But it's usually like a character-specific, more character-specific thing. As is R, and then F is your ultimate, which requires all your meter and does a lot of damage. So for those of you who've played Bloodline Champions, this game should be very familiar. It's a game basically taking entirely off Bloodline Champions with a couple small changes. Not much really has changed other than a few small things. A lot of it is small things. If you haven't played Bloodline Champions, this will probably, I mean, you've seen it, this will probably seem very familiar. Ow. Okay. Get out of there. This game should seem familiar to you. It does have a few differences. I find it's just generally a better flow as a game than Bloodline Champions was. So that's one thing I'm finding very enjoyable about it. I played through quite a bit of the beta, the open beta that was there for a while. Obviously I couldn't stream that, that was all under NDA. But yeah, that is the gist of it. So the goal of the game is a first to three, generally first to three, either 2v2 or 3v3 match between you and two others. My partner is playing the, I can't remember her name, it's basically the equivalent to the Ravener class of Bloodline Champions. Melee-based, hammer-based, throw, very electricity-based as well. Her abilities involve throwing hammers to stun people, setting up counterattacks, which then put the static effect on enemies, allowing you to deal extra damage if the static effect is on. One of them is actually a new character. Well, it's the Glutton from Bloodline Champions. I actually haven't had much of a chance to see that because, honestly, it was released today. So I'm not super familiar with what this iteration of that character does. What you see is what you get. The other one, which is Ashka or the Bloodline Champion Pyro, is basically that. Fire. Sets things on fire, given the ignite status, which allows dealing extra damage. And also just generally sets up a bunch of traps, a bunch of fire-based everything. Oh, whoops. Thought I had meter for that. So that's fire and get in my way to tank out everything. Like I said, I will actually double check that the abilities afterwards. I'll show them of the new hero. I'll also show more detailed ones I currently have after this match. So also, like I said, in between rounds you get these battle raids. They allow you to change the nature of your abilities. Which I realize, for those not familiar, it's kind of, I mean, what can I say? You don't know exactly what's normal, so in my case, I've essentially just made my disabling shot, which is my E button, hit somebody. Normally it hits somebody, and then if they do anything right afterwards, they can't do anything for about a second or two. But if I hit, because of the two changes I made, I get 12 bullets instead of 6 for my main attack, this one here, with the revolvers. The little number there. There are a lot of characters have that for charge abilities, which is a really nice feature. Bloodline Champions, I don't believe, even had anything remotely similar to that. I don't recall having anything like that. It was pretty much just straight cooldowns. That is one big change Battle Rite made, is they added charges as a thing. So abilities have charges, and those charges will recover over time. And in the case of my character, like, if I... Basically, in the case of my character, if I hit with the Stamina Shot ability, I end up getting more charges, which is nice. And of course, I also died. I think they're starting to get onto us. I am lightning. So now we get to see the Ravener. Unfortunately, the one thing I don't like that Bloodline Champions did do is that if you are observing somebody, you can actually see all of their abilities. I'm guessing that's going to be added later on. This is early access. Worth pointing out, it's actually pretty complete for early access, but it is early access. So there are probably features like a proper replay library and spectating that allows you to more easily look at every single character, as well as replays that allow you to look at every single character. That's all very important, and hopefully will be added over time. Until that happens, like until proper replays are in, I will continue to do first-person streams, as I am right now. But this is mainly an introduction, so of course, as I do them more, I will assume familiarity from the audience for what I am doing. And thus less explanations. So yeah, those of you familiar with the game, yeah, this is going to be a bit more explanation heavy because I am trying to focus for people who have probably never even heard of the game. I imagine most of my audience has not heard of this game. Oh boy. Ah! I'm being targeted! They know me! I'm being fairly targeted! I'm sorry, my teammate. I didn't mean to die. So yeah, for the most part, one of the biggest things about this game, which you probably notice, is all the little words popping up on top of everybody, is that status effects are a big deal in this game. A lot of characters, I'm pretty sure almost all characters, have some status effect that they inflict. Very often it's a status effect that synergizes with one of their abilities. So Ashka, for instance, has the Ignite status, which deals extra damage, like deals damage over time, which he then builds up while he's attacking. Ravener has the static ability, which deals extra damage as long as that's there when she hits certain attacks. And you also see counters popping up all the time. A lot of characters have counters in this game. Like, the main play I've noticed, counterplay or play and counterplay for attacks, is attacks around the timing of counters. And also occasionally around the timing of disables, but largely around the timing of counters. Yeah, see, now I have the ignite effect on me, which is not good. Okay, why are they targeting me? Quit targeting me. Would ya? I need the Ravener to be in the way so I can actually deal with things. I know, I'm calling a Ravener. I'll double-check the name afterwards. That was the name in Bloodline Champions, so that's why it's popping in my head as that. What's interesting, actually, about this game, also, it's not super obvious in this match because there aren't any healers, but healers... Especially compared to Bloodline Champions. I mean, Bloodline Champions already kind of had a healer system that was more of a skill-based thing that wasn't really all that required. Like, it wasn't like you needed a healer to survive. But in Bloodline, in Battle Rite, they've added Battle Rites for most characters that basically give them... Okay, there we go. That basically give them the ability to heal up. In my case, disabling shots on success with the Battle Rites I picked. Heal me! Alright, who are we against? Oh, okay, some newer players. Wait, no, that's some newer players, that's grade 10. Huh, okay, interesting. Woo. And then, of course, all the screens with all the little things. Yeah, this game actually also borrows a lot from Overwatch in terms of how it does loot systems and how it does... I think it has a chest system that you'll probably see in a few games. Now, the champions, let's go over this first. So yeah, my main character, Jade, the gunner. Not really anything here I haven't shown already. I'm pretty sure I went through every single ability. So it's she shoots quickly. She fires a shot that stuns people. With energy, she fires a quick shot that locks people in place for about a second. She jumps away, stunning nearby enemies. Her big thing is stunning and, to a lesser extent, disabling. Like, using silence. And then hide it, going invisible. Though this is just invisible, not immaterial. There is an immaterial status, which you can get from the EX version. And then, you saw this, I was using this a lot, locks down people's abilities, they just can't do anything. Like, they can't use any abilities. They can move, and that's it. And then essentially shotgun blast and explosions around everywhere. So this is the guy seeing before, which I believe is based on the Glutton from Bloodline Champions. I have not seen what this person does. I'm not going to go over it in all detail. I'm not going to go over all the heroes. I just hadn't seen what they do. I'm curious actually what this new hero is. Let's see. Not really my style, but let's check it out. So it is attacking, which increases the damage of your M2. And that was stunning. It's a counter. So Q is a counter. E is just artillery. And get off me abilities. Okay. And EX mode is, ooh, wow. Internal healing. That's kind of neat. And slowing down enemies. Okay, so EX mode internal healing. That's interesting. Let's try this. Not my style, but I am trying to show off the game. I don't just want to show Gunners all or Jade all the time. So we shall show Rook. This. Oh, I see. As opposed to normal. Okay, so normally it's 17. With full charge, it's 20. I don't understand. Is that like one damage per? No, 14 plus 2 for every single charge. All right, that makes sense. Interesting. Alright, so it looks like this character is built entirely around the Berserk status, which is apparently built up by... Oh, I see. You increase attack speed, movement speed, and become temporarily invulnerable. That's... Is that all part of the same status? Huh. Alright, well... Let's trigger it all the time, then. Why not? And against, ooh, against a Gunner player who's going for evasion. Now, I mentioned before about stealth. It can, with the right battle right, turn you immaterial, which means that Jade has a better option for countering things. If I'm trying to do something, me or the Ashka I'm with tries to do something, and I'm gonna walk into the... Ah! Oh. Okay. So you just get extra abilities. Okay, so Berserk reduces cooldown, apparently. Ah, I almost healed up. I feel silly. Like I said, not my main style. Gotta remember, heal up. We have no healers. They do have a healer, actually. That Pearl, the Ocean Mage, is the one over there. This is a healer. And she does a lot of she's not the most healery healer, but most healers in Battle Rite are not focused super on... Like, they have healing as a thing they do. With the exception of the Alchemist, they basically don't heal as the main thing. And even the Alchemist has a lot of other disabling abilities. But a lot of times the support characters aren't... They're only kind of healers because there aren't really healers as a thing. That's mainly why. So, she's more about disabling. Stopping projectiles, stopping people from moving. Basically, control. So I'm gonna have to deal with that, especially being as I'm playing a melee hero, need to get close and focus. Probably should focus her down. Hmm. Oh. Which one's smack? Ah, my R ability, okay. Alright, so the Gunner's going for everything stealthy. And it looks like the Ocean Mage is going for all the barriers they can, which kind of makes sense given that Ashka's a bit of a pain. Get that healer out of there! Ah, shoot. Oops. And of course now I'm in the problem. That would have been a perfect time to counter. Because I know when snipe's happening. Yeah, this is the effect of silence. Oof, shoot. I have a bad feeling we're not going to win this, mainly because I don't know how to play this character very well. I mean, this is pretty much a new character. Also, when enemies die, you get a charge, which is nice. Ooh. Ah, shoot. Yeah, this is not going to go well for me. So, just... This is curious, though. I'm interested. This is an interesting character. I don't really want to play it too much, but... It's always good to know what's there. Oh, we actually have one. Never mind. That was our win. Why did I think that was their win? Alright, never mind. We're good. Oh, interesting. How do you generate the armor break ability? Oh, I see. That creates armor break. Alright, so now I'm healing up with my smack ability and... My M2 causes people to deal less damage. And I didn't see what they were doing. Shoot. That's what I need to care about. What are my opponents up to? That's the cool thing about this game, though. You actually can know these things. Like, you aren't stuck just... It's public information. I really like that aspect of it. Like, that makes a lot of sense to me. Because you're dealing with something that changes things that you wouldn't know about unless you saw them. And you don't know what things people are going to use. So there's always that, I guess, that aspect of information, hidden information in there regardless. Ah, shoot. That's a pretty good gunner. Oh. Yeah, pretty good gunner. Okay, ah, they're going for extra snipe damage. Can go for extra damage. Hey, so are they. Okay, so yeah, this ocean mage is going entirely around bubbles. They want to block everything. I noticed they're countering a lot too. I've got to be careful about that. Either that or I got to focus down the gunner. Because here I was thinking I should have focused down the others, like the healer. Because normally you do want to focus down the healer. But this is one of those cases where it seems like that's not the case at all. Oh boy. I walked into that one. I'm gonna probably play a variety of heroes tonight. I think the next one I'm gonna play is another one I really enjoyed. Which is actually really appropriate to some of my earliest work. Which is basically a time manipulation character. At least thematically speaking. Which I find quite interesting to play. Yeah, so that is the new hero. It's very scary, but I don't really find that style to my liking. Anyhow. Hooray, I got a level. Alright, where are you? Older, there we go. This guy is cool. This guy is all about basically dealing damage to everybody you're against. I switch over to 3v3 as well. Basically a matter of dealing damage to everybody you're fighting, and then using... Yeah, the quicksand ability. Very similar to the last hero, it's a projectile thrown in an area that bombs the area out, except in this case, it consumes a status effect that this Sands of Time attack causes, dealing extra damage. Basically, everything I'm trying to do is this Sands of Time thing, which is I hit them with my left mouse button attack, they get this status effect that after, as you can see, 3.5 seconds, it'll explode, and I can trigger it using a bunch of other things. So I can use Quicksand to trigger it, I can use a EXM1 to trigger it, I can use, with some of my battle rights, I can use the space ability to trigger it. It's really nice. There's a lot of different ways to trigger it. And that's pretty much the entire playstyle. Like that. Bam. Okay. So I am with Ashka and a Shifu, the spear wielder. Okay, I want to do... We're against Alchemist. Okay, I want to use this. So much like the Ocean Mage I was talking about last game, this character does set up bubbles as a thing. Q ability... Sorry, not Q ability. The EX Q ability sets up a bubble, but I have actually set it up so that that'll happen if I use a space ability. So yeah, this is a healer. The Alchemist is pretty much the purest healer I've found. I mean, so am I. I'm also a healer, but... Get out of here. Oh, shoot. Not what I wanted to do. Okay, I've got some... The other thing I can do is take abilities and throw them back. Ow, what the heck? Alright, another thing I can do is take abilities, throw them back. And, oh great, we're down to the one Ashka. Ashka is considered extremely powerful, mostly because of his ultimate. Which, clearly, that's what we're seeing... Well... Maltaruba is trying to go for that, but clearly that didn't happen. Okay. So yeah, Shifu is probably the most... I don't want to say the most counter-oriented character, but you do have to be careful about their counter. They like to counter stuff. I'm going to go for Fading's Time. We have to remember to actually Sands of Time things. Which is kind of tricky. But yeah, I'll remember it. Oddly enough, despite the simplicity of a lot of the characters, I do find changing characters to be rather tricky in this game. It's something that I find difficult to do over the course of several matches, like switch around between them. Ah, they were material at the time. Oops. Okay, that was a mistake. You need healing. You need healing. Let me heal you. Let me heal you. I've got your back. Nice. Yeah, that's the other thing. That'll actually send projectile back. If used properly. And now to stun them out. My ultimate just basically stuns enemies. Which is great for setting up the Sands of Time stuff. Ah, missed. Sorry, Spiel Wielder. I can't say I'm that used to 3v3. I've got to be honest, I normally play 2v2, but I figure... It is, as far as I know, the main game mode. Like, I don't know if it's supposed to be. It wasn't Bloodline Champions, so I'm guessing it's meant to be the main game mode here as well. Ultimate ready. And back we go. Now die. Oh, what? I didn't have... Right, of course I wouldn't have the energy, but I used it all for my ultimate. That was silly. Here I'm trying to go my ultimate, in, which uses all of my energy, into one of my EX moves, which requires energy. Great move. Not what I intended to do. Alright. They're kind of close to each other, I guess? I feel like this is more useful. Give people shields. Otherwise, I'm just... not really doing the right thing. I feel like I really need to be more defensive in here. In a 2v2 environment, Older is great at just dealing raw damage. In a 3v3 environment, I feel like Older's far more suited to just helping people out. Like being supportive and providing... Oh, I got a thing. Like being supportive, adding a bit of damage here and there, adding status effects, healing where necessary. And yes, it requires accuracy in order to actually hit people in this game. Ooh. I think... Oops. I didn't mean to do that on them. That's one of those weird things where I feel like that's going to be far more useful in a case where you have communication. Like, really active communication. Otherwise, it just doesn't really work. Because you're basically moving your teammate around without them knowing they're going to do that. That ultimate ability can, it moves teammates or it moves you. It's up to you, it's up to the player. Ah. It's up to the person controlling Older, whether or not it's gonna, well, which one's gonna do. And hey, we're actually taking rounds. Does seem that I need to be more of a the support hero and not try to frontline things. Because that doesn't apparently work in 3v3 as it does in 2v2. It works really well in 2v2. That's a thing. But in 3v3, clearly it does not work. Let's see. I want to get... I think reducing both damage and healing is probably a good idea. I seem to be getting better at getting Sands of Time on people. I mean, the thing is, you want to get Sands of Time on everybody at all times. And that's tricky. Because you have to hit them, and then you have to hit all of them, and cycle between them. And then, of course, trying to throw bombs like that, and also bearing in mind what's going on here. This is a very management-oriented hero. Let's see. Okay. That's the panic status, which causes you to run away when you get hit by it, as would be suggested by the name. And that ball in the center is gets you energy. Just gets a bunch of extra energy. Oops, that's what I want to do. I want to heal you. Then you... Get Sands of Time on both of you. No! Aha! We're taking this back. The Shifu burned badly, but the rest of us lived. And was apparently the MVP. Well, by a small margin. Alright, so... Let's see... I haven't really been using my ultimate too much. Like I said, Older is a character that you kind of need communication to make the ultimate work. Otherwise, it doesn't really work all that well, which is kind of annoying. All right, you go, and let's hopefully finish this in our favor. Also, I should point out, you actually do get access to the mounts at all times. So it's not just a matter of getting... Oh, I should have gone for the Sands of Time Explodes one. I mean, I am keeping their damages down, which is good. Okay. Heal up! Heal up! Don't die! Darn it! I gotta remember to hold control. You can hold control to cast things on yourself specifically. Which is very key to keeping yourself alive and... Crap. Well, that's game. I mean, the Ashka might be able to do something, but... 3-on-1! I failed them. I'm sorry. Part of me feels like I should go back to playing Gunner just to show how the game plays with a character that I actually know more how to play. Because I don't really know how to play Older all that well. I mean, as we're clearly, I'm exploring as I'm going, which I've played Older quite a bit in the beta, but I don't know Older that well. I'm gonna play Older once more. After that, I'm not sure what I want to do. There are a couple other champions on my show. I feel like I do want to show more champions. That's the thing. I want to show the champions that you get an idea broadly of what's there. And that'll make it easier, assuming that a replay system comes up that is better than just these little plays. And that there's a way of actually doing regular casts of matches. Very nice. But yeah, so I guess I've really got to be focusing more... Keeping backline. I'm just used to the way... In 2v2, like I said, you can frontline it. I probably should have gone for a 2v2 game, actually. Just to demonstrate what I was talking about last match. Okay, so I'm here, we have Ravener, we have Pyro, or Ashka. I forgot to look up the Ravener's name! Shoot! Hello. Yeah, in Bloodline Champions, everything was by class, as would be implied by my constant use of class, rather than anything else. Okay. This will come up a lot. But at the same time, rooting enemies against this composition, especially the Gunner and the Spear Wielder, or Jade and Shifu, that's definitely the way to go. But yeah, Bloodline Champions with my class, rather than Battle Rite, which has specific names. Oh, right, I guess that does work. Oops. Okay. Oh wait, this is... Oh, I love it when I'm against a Jade. I went for the wrong thing. Why did I go for my E ability? The cool thing about me fighting Jade as older is that as soon as I see a snipe coming, because I kind of know when a snipe's likely to happen, which will be pretty soon now, actually. There it is. Ah! I wasn't in there. Because since I play Jade, like since I main Jade, it's so easy for me to just basically deal with that. Because, what I do? I just wait until I get snipe, and then I snipe. Because I know how to do snipe. And it's so nice to fight. Like, that was actually one of the things I was finding when I first played older. I was against a lot of Jade teams. Or, get Jade and somebody else. And it made it really easy to get into older and win games with older, because I was just basically half playing Jade. So let's see. Rejuvenating Sand, Renew... I feel like I'm going to go for as much immobilization as possible. That's what I want to do against this composition. For the most part, I find a lot of people will just go for they'll go for a Battle Rite set that's just their set. At least I found that during the beta. A lot of people just had a Battle Rite set. They didn't really change it up for composition. Oh, how did I miss that? I can't believe I missed that. That's actually surprising to me. Ah, I got it. Yes, there we go. That's a hit. Okay, they're getting a lot of free shots on me. Oh no, ah! Seriously? Just about hit the Q key there. Alright, well. That Ashka might be able to deal enough damage. No, Ignite didn't quite get rid of it. Wow, seriously, three health. Three health Majin Buu has. Ashka almost did the job as needed, but unfortunately not enough, and down goes, well... Jukes, I think, was actually the Ashka player. So close. So very close, but not close enough. Alright, Pillowham, very good, or decent, oh, actually, no, they're clearly a good player. Especially a good Gunner player. So... I think they're getting close enough that this will be viable. I regretted not doing it last time, but that was a different composition, a different game. However, I do notice they are sticking together a lot. And this will either... Actually, wait, no, what am I talking about? I was fighting that Jade on their own the entire time. Because I was trying to prove a point about Jade and about... my fighting Jade as a thing that I find easier to do than most others. Ah, don't die. Don't die. Throw one bullet. Actually, they might have been waiting for me to do that, come to think of it. All right, I rooted the one I wanted to. I really wanted to root Shifu of all people. There we go. What? Oh, seriously? That Shifu's ultimate got me. I totally missed that. Once again, Juke's back, the last person on the team left, so they're pretty much... I don't know if they have much of a chance. I mean, they, ultimate gonna go in, get maybe one? Maybe, whatever. Gonna hit Majin Buu, but not even enough. Sheesh. Alright, this is... part of the reason I prefer playing 2v2, it's easier to kind of coordinate things. Or to even see what was going on. Okay, so they're trying to reduce cooldowns more than anything. And I was trying to... Oh. Let's try this. I've actually never tried this one before. I've been using the E ability a lot, Quicksand, so that will apparently heal now. Alright. Ah, wasn't there when I needed it to be. Eh, I got it. Let's see if I can get a position that makes it work. No, I can't. Well, screw you then. Oh, wow. Okay, almost died. Not what I want. What? No. Okay, I'm probably going to go back to Gunner. I'll show a couple other heroes afterwards. But, yeah, not older. Not if I'm going to lose. I can only do so much losing on stream with characters I don't main. Because, yeah, it's like, I'm trying to play older as a damage dealer, which works fine in 2v2 and not in 3v3, so forget it. Somebody else. Not playing as a healer. And hey, I got a chest, because that's a thing. Thank you. So yeah, chests are a thing. Kind of like Overwatch, you get chests, they give you stuff. Oh. I got cool guns. I might check them out at some point. But yeah, it's a cosmetic thing. As far as I can tell, the free-to-play model is going to be that you buy champions as well as buying cosmetics, but you can get early access and get all the champions forever, apparently. So, that's cool. There's another character. Oh, yeah. Tai is pretty cool. Little tricky. Boomerang-based. The main thing kind of centered around this X-Strike ability, which is essentially target your boomerangs at a point, and then if they hit the opponent at that point, they deal extra damage. Or loads of damage. That's pretty much her thing. A lot of, and also quite a bit of things where things are going down and then coming back. Because it's boomerangs, of course. That's how boomerangs are generally envisioned to work in media. It's a bit trickier than that, but yeah, that's the idea. So, she's pretty neat. Another cool hero I enjoy playing. Haven't played that much. But it is more of a direct damage hero, so that'll work. And actually, the only hero, as far as I know, that uses their mount as part of their main ability. Her ultimate will summon her mount, which, like I said, you can summon during the match. I haven't actually done that. The last couple of games have been on relatively small maps, so I haven't needed to. But yeah, stuff comes back. And when it comes back, it deals a bit less damage every time. Or it deals loads of damage, because it's... that's how it works. Alright, so I have Psychopomp and Rannet Assassin. Okay, that's cool. So that's our healer, and that is basically super stealthy damage dealer. Like, super stealthy assassin type. Doesn't do a whole lot if they get hit. Hopefully this particular player, I think it's Croak, yeah, Croak's the name. So Croak, Paloma, and Taya. That's the character name. Versus older Jade and another Croak. They're probably a better older than I was. But are they a better Jade than I was? That's a good question. They're most definitely a better Taya than I am. Ah, shoot. Oh, right, they got a Croak too. See, one thing about Croak is that Croak actually has, for me, his EX stealth allows him to completely incapacitate an enemy for a period of time. Which is annoying to deal with. Okay, so I'm basically trying to play crowd control here. That's all I can really do. Just... ooh. Ah, shoot, I was too far away. The neat thing is a lot of my abilities center around either pushing people away or bringing people together. Like a therapist for people fighting in this arena. Except for the pushing people away part. That's not so much a therapist's job. Actually, it's more of a diplomat. A very aggressive diplomat with boomerangs. Perhaps all diplomats should have boomerangs. That'd make international relations more interesting if a little bit more heated. then he can go hunting. Ah, yes, they do actually know about the EX one. Yeah, that's the one I was talking about. So the Croak player knows about that. They're using that fairly well, actually. They might be the ones I was playing with before. I played with one during the beta that was basically doing incapacitates all the time. They were really good at that. I believe that might be them. Or if not, then it's somebody else who also knows how to use incapacitate. Actually, no, never mind. The one who was using incapacitate made sure not to hit people. Because that actually didn't help a lot. Ooh. I don't know, for this group, would I even hit with that? We have two enemies that stealth a lot. I'm gonna go for this. They stealth a lot, but having the ability to just lock down an area for a couple seconds is still gonna be handy. Especially since that would help Paloma's abilities hit, because Paloma has a lot of kind of tricky abilities that are difficult to hit with. Oh, nice! Actually managed to get that. Ah, shoot. Get out of there. Get away from her. Bastard. Oh, right, that's what I want to use when I'm dealing with enemies. That's my crowd control move, is the tornado. I forgot to use that. Stupid wall. Alright, might just go back to Gunner to stop embarrassing myself. One more. It shall happen again. Yeah, that is a really good older, apparently. I haven't been noticing if they've been throwing Sands of Time on everything, though. They probably have been. I feel like they have been. Okay. Huh. That could work well. Like, Windbomb X Strike, this is the two things here. The one is the vortex that sucks everyone in. The other one is that the two red boomerangs that deal a bunch of damage when they hit. Okay. Darn it, you're annoying. Oh, what? I missed? Oh, I almost got it in time. No. Get away from me. Darn it. Almost grabbed enough energy to deal with that. Oh, looks like the older one for the Sands of Time explodes ability. Ultimate? Oh, okay, so Paloma's ultimate is a bunch of healing and a bunch of damage in an area. Wow, that is a gold older player. Their time benders are on point. I mean, they're basically reflecting everything they need to. I mean, a good croak could actually deal with all that. Oh, okay, I shouldn't have said that right before they died. Like, barely, it's tough, but it's like doing it just right, a croak could theoretically deal with a 1-on-3 situation, but that's really tough. All right, well, that didn't help any. All right, let's go back to Jade. Let's stop embarrassing ourselves and play our main. I wonder if they're going to add new modes. In Bloodline Champions, they had a lot of different modes that weren't just arena, or a couple different modes. They had one that was, I believe, an area capture, and another one that was capture the flag. It'd be kind of neat if they had that. The arena thing's fun, though. No real issues there. But yeah, like I said, it really is going to come down to whether or not replays come up as a thing that's easily available. Like, it would either have to be something where there's a replay system that is like gamereplays.org, where there's a public thing that people just upload replays to, or it would have to be something through this Odium system. As far as I can tell, this does not work very well, and even then, replays, as far as I can tell, do not really allow for proper spectating, or spectator side. Hopefully that will change. I don't know if it'll be the case all the time, but hopefully it'll change. Because I kind of need that too. It'd also be nice if the matchmaker actually found me somebody pretty soon. Actually, one thing I think is kind of annoying. It seems like the matchmaker doesn't take into account how much experience you have with the characters. Because I feel like that's kind of an issue. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's just... I feel like it should do that, but yeah, it just seems like... It should take into account the fact that you haven't played a character a whole lot compared to your main. Maybe it does. The grades are a very broad system. There's a lot of variation in... decent amount of variation in skill, or at least a large range of their skill points within any given grade. So I'm not quite sure where that lies, or how that all works internally. I was just thinking, because it seems to be having a hard time finding me a match right now when I'm playing Jade, as opposed to when I was playing Older or Taya, where it was finding matches just no problem. Come on, I want a 3v3 with Jade. You can do some cool stuff with snipes. Getting 3 snipes in a row. It's actually where stealth becomes useful. Your stealth ability in 2v2 is almost... it's not useless, but it's very difficult to make super useful because your opponents are always aware of your position. 3v3, it's a lot easier to get lost in the chaos. So it's a lot easier to just use stealth, position yourself, set up a snipe, set up a disabling shot, whatever. Just set up something. In 2v2, the immaterial one, Smoke Veil, that makes it really great for just getting out of jam, but doesn't really make it super useful for just using stealth as stealth. Like for actually just hiding, getting around. There's no particular bonus, unlike with Croak, where he gets either stun or incapacitate as a status effect, so it just stops an opponent. Like, hit somebody, they stop acting for like a second or two, until someone hits them. Hey, seriously? Is this where we must end? Are we gonna end tonight on matchmaking, just not finding me anybody? That would suck. I would hope that that doesn't happen. Looks like it might, though. No, I really wanted to show off 3v3 with Jade. Maybe I'll find some in 2v2. Whoa, what? Oh. 2v2, I'm pretty sure, is going to be easier just due to the lack of play, or the lack of player requirements. You only need to have, like, 4 players. Which isn't that much less than 6, granted, but at the same time, you only need to have 4 players that are within a close skill range, which, depending on the skill range, mind you, I'm middling at this point, so I don't really know how it would be that hard. And there's apparently thousands of people playing right now, so I have no idea. I'm actually kind of curious, what are the numbers right now? Because what is Steam charts? Oh, wait, somebody. Let's see, Battlerite currently has, apparently... oh, come on. 0 player, what? No, it has 6,000 players. Or 4,000 players. Should not be this hard to find players. Well, I think this might be the end of the stream. It'd be really nice if replays were a thing. There's also no way for me to, for instance, join somebody's game. Like, private is private. You have to be invited. You can't just join a server list. It's not custom, exactly. If it were, I could theoretically just join random games and spectate and commentate on them, but... that I can't do, because it's not a thing. I imagine for tournaments they'll have that as a thing. Well, actually, no, tournaments probably be different. Bloodline Champions had a built-in tournament system. I'm guessing Battlerite will as well, and as a result we'll have some spectating set up for that as well. Though on the other hand, those were automated tournaments that were kind of a weekly thing. Not tournaments that you have, like, big deal tournaments that you'd have commentators for as a regular thing. Ah, here we go. Finally got a match. Who am I with? I am with a... okay, I'm against a Taya and one of the Raveners. I'm with a Croak! Alright, so all the stealth heroes versus, I guess, all the statusy heroes?
How you doing?
Yo.
Oh, I see. Let's see, against this setup... I think against this setup, I'm gonna want to stealth a fair amount. This also reduces the cooldown of Smoke Veil, but I don't feel like a croak is going to need that so much. All right. So, I'm gonna go for... Oh, shoot. So I gotta be careful about that Ravener. Whoa, what the? That's a new mount. Because remember, the Taya's player, I mean, Taya is one of those... Oh, I guess that's the ultimate fan pack thing. Like, Taya is one of those weird characters who basically wants you to very specific range and not moving. Ooh, that was good timing. That was really good timing. Get out of here. What? Oh, Root. Root is a much less useful ability than I generally think it'll be. Oh, crap.
Ultimate ready. Eat this.
Ooh, nice. What? Ha, you didn't time that right. Their counter was a bit too early. Although, if I'd gone for the EX one, which actually would have been a... Like, that was actually an interesting counterplay, because if I'd gone for the EX M2, which probably they were expecting, it would have been faster, and it would have hit their counter. But because I went for the regular one, which would have been riskier and probably suicide had they not gone for a counter, I ended up not dying. Which is pretty cool. I'm not sure if that's what they were thinking, though, but I feel like that would be the mind game in general. At least with this, is because, you know, the timing's just being that much different. If they were thinking that, that's awesome. If they're not thinking that, well, I imagine that later on, like, as the game gets better developed... Oh, why am I using this? This range. Okay. Where is your partner? Oh, not quite close to the stun. Darn it. Get hit. Oh, did I seriously not hit both of them? I can't believe I didn't quite hit both of them. Stun pierces, so that's why I'm trying to do that. What? Oh, I should have gone for Shift Q. That would have saved my life. Would have gone immaterial just in time. All right. That's fine, that's fine, we can deal with that. Man, if I had just gotten immaterial that 1 second sooner. So, yeah, I want to use that. Holy crap, I ever want to use that. Free healing. Well, admittedly, extra snipe bonus. Snipe bonus damage is nice. And I was going for stealth, so that was a bit of an anti-synergy pick. And yeah. Oh, apparently we're the only ones going for that. Oh, never mind. The Taya already went for the extra health on Windstrike. Assuming she hits. Ooh. Ha, healed the attack. I'm actually surprised how little that works as a... Get out of here. Ah, I didn't fall for it. One thing I do notice is that I am screwing up a lot of that blast fault. Like, that my jump... In Bloodline Champions, it used to be backwards. Like, you'd... Oh, shoot. Oh. Ah. Oh, good. I did it in time. Didn't do that in time, though. That would have been... Like, if I had gone... I would have had to go immaterial immediately, and I would have gotten out of there. You're being separated. Me and my partner are being separated. That's not good. As much as I seem to be wanting to play 1v1, that's not the game. Alright, I want to... get more energy. I always want more energy. Okay, so the Ravener's going for Haste, and the... and Taya's going for the Slayer. So I gotta be careful about that. Oh, shoot, they hit me. Wait, why did I go for the regular one? Should've gone for this one. Root one. The root one. Darn it! Darn it, darn it, darn it, darn it! Ah, shoot. Oh, I'm dead. Try my best, but I'm dead. Darn it. This is so embarrassing. I need to win at least a few matches. Come on. Oh well, so much for winning with Gunner, I guess. Alright, one more, and that'll be it for tonight. So hopefully that's a decent introduction. Like I said, I do want to actually cast this rather than just play it, because I prefer to cast things. I'd rather not play while commentating. I don't enjoy doing that. So yeah, Stunlock Studios, watch this. Please, please have a proper public replay system so I can actually just see what everyone's played. Rather than this thing where people have to post up and apparently I have to follow people or something. Like, what is this? This is not Twitter. I find it so annoying that replay systems aren't available half the time. Like, it's just, I don't know, I'm used to games that have it. Oh wow, two people going for Rook. And someone going for Virus, the inhibitor. We have not seen Virus yet, the inhibitor. Basically all about shields and, well, inhibiting. Hi there. Stopping people from doing things. Countering, shielding, blocking, and then just damaging stuff. Okay, I'm gonna want this. Meterless immaterial. That actually would have saved my life a lot last match had I gone for that instead of the stealth cooldown one. I wasn't using stealth as often as I would have liked, as I probably should have. But yeah, meterless get out of shit free card. Get out of all the crap. Like, oh no, I'm gonna get killed. I wouldn't have gotten killed. There are many opportunities I would have had to avoid getting killed, so I'm going to take advantage of that now. Especially with this, the Rook's going to be coming at me. Ooh, nice. Double stun. Oh, what? Seriously? I will beat the crap out of you. Oof. Nice! We got a good first round. Mostly because I guess our Rook is better than their Rook, because that was basically all the fight was those two Rooks just going at it. That was it. And me just beating on Varish. Being on Super Saiyan. Super Saiyan Hoka. Whereas apparently Dark Shadow is better than Dunga at playing Rook. And I want to do. More frequent sniping. Oh, wait, no, that doesn't work with the other. With the metered snipe. With Snapshot. I forgot about that. I mean, if I'm stealthing fairly often, I should be able to pull off snipes. But Snapshot's super handy. No longer invincible. Ah, I got both of them. Nice. Gotta love Root. Oh, crap. That was way too risky. Give me those energy balls. Heal me up. Ah, crap. I think I was dead. Come on, Duncan. Kill the Varish. Are you gonna kill it? Okay, it looks like the Varish has got some good shield going on there. And one ultimate. Are you gonna hit? You hit! And there we go. Going for the final Berserk to win. Nicely done. Dark Shadow knows what they're doing. And apparently only start. Wow, really? I'm impressed. Apparently they only just started. Either that or it's a new account, but it probably is just they only started. I'm going for snipe more than I am for anything else. So let's continue with the snipe synergy. And... oof. Okay, so I gotta deal with my movement speed being reduced on me, apparently. So Dung is gone for. Oh, so close. Thank you, my... thank you, Dark Shadow. Oops, I thought I was close enough to make him immaterial. Oh crap, that was bad timing. Okay, they're dead. We win! Hooray! I shot a dude! Lots of times! And eventually they died! The people here are very resilient to bullets, or my bullets are made of, like, tin or something. Hey, we won a game. And stuff happens, and for some reason I have any XP boost, and I got another chest! Hooray! Ending on a Skinner boxy note. Of stuff. Hey, more stuff. Okay, that's cool. Anyway, that was Battle Rite, so hope you enjoyed that. I intend to cast it frequently. Hopefully, with actual replays. Actually, if you play this game and you have replays, please send them to me, or somehow get them to me so I can cast them. I realize games are likely only going to be 5 to 10 minutes long, so I'm going to need, like, 5 or 6 of them. But still, please do that. It would make my life a lot easier. Assuming that... I mean, if Sunlock does set up a more comprehensive replay system, that'd be awesome. If they do that, great. If they don't do that, I'm gonna rely on people sending replays or telling me, hey, we're playing a first to three or something, and then having a private game. Anyhow, hope you enjoyed that. That's it for me tonight, so have a good night, everyone. And thanks for watching.